All right. Hey, guys. Welcome to another Tech Saturday with just Eric. So this week, I feel like we're going to jump into what we saw in the last video where my NAS drive was dead. We're going to replace it. So we'll get into that right after the intro. Roll that intro. Alright guys, so it was a 6 terabyte drive, so we're going to have to replace it with this Iron Wolf. It's an Iron Wolf 6 terabyte NAS drive. We'll be replacing that. So the first thing we have to do is stop the array and shut the NAS down. So let's jump into screen recording now. So here we are on the desktop. We got to launch our web browser, go to our unRAID login screen. I love LastPass. Does anyone else have LastPass? Let me know in the comments. Okay, so we need to go to the array, and we have to click the stop, and this will ask you, do you want to? And you say yes. If you just did like a shutdown here, it wouldn't take the array offline. So when you replace the disk, it may, I'm not sure if it would, but it may have issues with you swapping a drive without stopping the array before you shut it down. All right, you see our drives we have here. We have 2 parity 6 terabyte drives. And just to note, as with any NAS or any parity drives, you wanna make sure that the parity matches. So if you have a 6 terabyte drive, you need to replace it with a 6 terabyte drive. On unRAID, it doesn't really matter what you have as far as other drives, because you can see I have 2 2 terabyte drives. Actually, 3 2-terabyte drives and 1 6-terabyte drive. You know, it's just what I had at the time when I started. I moved the drives over from unRAID to here, and the one parity drive was like a refurbished drive, so I knew it didn't have a lot of life left in it. But anyway, so now we have to go to shut down, and then it'll prompt you, do you want to shut down? You say, yep. And then it says the system is going down. So basically here, you just wait till your NAS turns itself off. So it'll probably be, you know, a wind down, maybe 20 seconds or something. So, all right, we're down. So let's go jump over here to the NAS and get to some replacing. All right, so I went ahead and took the liberty of bringing the NAS over to the table and taking the back off. So the joy and the curse of this case is it has these sliders for your drive mounts, which is good, but for some reason I put the drive in the second slot, not the first slot, so bear with me for a second. Gotta unscrew the drive. Don't look at my cable management. It's what you call shove it in there and make it look, you know, make it look acceptable, or, you know, pray that it works. I don't know, whichever one. Okay, so we're gonna take the drive out, unplug it. All right, so there's our bad drive. It's 6 terabytes. Good drive going in. It's a Seagate as well, but the other one was an enterprise drive that was refurbished and probably, as I should have learned, don't buy refurbished, especially in something that's as critical as a NAS. Anyway, alrighty. Make sure you line up the holes with the rubber grommets. All right, make sure we've got our power plugged in. Power and SATA. Okay, spin it around, slide it back in the channel. Okay. Thumb screws. I just get them started. Then you can use the screwdriver because it's a little bit easier. All right, and we've installed our drives. So let's jump back into the screen recording, and I'll show you how to reassign your drive in unRAID to the parity drive. So as you can see, we are in unRAID again. It says the disk returned to normal operation. We see parity drive 1 is unassigned. So if we choose the drop down, we see our 6 terabyte drive. We'll go ahead and choose that. It says all existing data will be overwritten. Since it's a new drive, it doesn't matter. And then once you click start, it says start will parity sync and data rebuild. So we're gonna click start. Give it a few seconds. see up here, our smart disk parity rebuild is happening. So as you can see here, we'd be going for less than a minute. And we got 18 hours and 36 minutes to go. So we will probably pick this up tomorrow. It's gonna rebuild the whole parity on 6 terabytes. So what, oh, it jumped down to 15 hours. It'll probably be like 8 hours, but by then the light will be totally bad. So we'll just pick this up tomorrow for me. I'll be in the same shirt. Probably. So anyway, and then we'll see it to completion. So I'll see you guys in a second. All right. Many hours later, I think it took like 10 or 12 hours. They had to rebuild, 6 terabytes. So I get it. But let's jump back into the screen recording and I'll show you what it looks like. Okay, back here. And as you can see, the Parity Sync data rebuild. It took 11 hours and 46 minutes, 39 seconds with an average write speed of 141.5 megabits per second. So not too bad. The Parity disk returned to normal operation. So we got both Parity disks back online. So now we have redundant drives back up and running, thank goodness. So I guess I'll jump out of this and we'll wrap it up. All right, guys, so I hope you like that. One suggestion I do have, if you're gonna do this, would be to make sure that you have your server, your NAS, whatever, connected to a UPS. You want battery backup just in case you have a power outage or something, because it's been kind of stormy here for the past couple days. So I didn't need it, but I was plugged into a UPS. I'm always plugged into a UPS on my unRAID server, but just a helpful hint. If you does go down while you're rebuilding the parity, then it's not good. So you want to make sure that you have some sort of battery backup. Other than that, I hope you guys like this video. Drop a like if you liked it. Do all the YouTube things, share it with your friends, drop a comment, let me know how I did on Tech Saturday redo or whatever we're calling this. We also, if you'd like to support the channel, we have a Ko-fi page. You can find that link here. That just drops us a virtual tip jar. So in case you don't want to do like the Patreon, which is a monthly subscription, you can do that. Thanks a lot for watching. We'll catch you in the next one. Peace and love.